This video contains spoilers for The Wheel of Time, Season 2, Episode 6.
Episode 6, Eyes Without Pity, written by Rami Park, directed by Maya Vervillo. Egwene is dragged into a bare stone cell by her new soldame, Rena. Egwene tries to beat the hell out of her, but learns the hard way that any pain she tries to inflict on Rena, she feels twice over. Same thing with trying to remove her new collar, an item. Rena wants to be her friend, but then tortures her into telling her name, so good start. The moment Rena leaves, Egwene tries to grab the bracer she's left on a hook, but her pain is so intense she vomits. Puke count. 1. In the Teleron Riad Desert, Lanfear continues to manipulate Rand. She tells him that she's been protecting his dreams from Ishamael, and that he plans to turn all Rand's friends to the dark to control him. Rand says Lanfear needs to give him a reason to trust her, and when he stands up to her, he reminds her of Luz. Aw. She tells him she will help him on one condition. Rand wakes up in Moraine's house in Kyrian, where Moraine is still standing over him, watching. He says Lanfear's condition was that he leave Moraine. She admits to him that she did have Loghain brought to Kyrian to teach him. Ignoring her protestations, Rand leaves. Matt and Min have arrived in the foregate of Kyrian. Matt is fully into all the partying that's going on, but Min looks incredibly uncomfortable and wants to leave. Why? Just because the top Forsaken is controlling every move you make? Nynaeve and Elaine are bickering in the attic of Rima Sadai and her warder, Basan. Rima and Basan bring them some tea, and Rima recognizes Nynaeve's wisdom belt. The girls tell Rima about Liandrin breaking her oaths. Rima is horrified to learn of the true existence of the Black Aja. Liandrin is visiting her son when Lanfear appears. She asks Liandrin why she works for Ishamael when she hates men. She figures out Liandrin swore her oaths to the dark to keep her son alive, but since he's holding her back, Lanfear will just go ahead and kill him for her. Hey, Liandrin, how's your dead son? Loyal is doing his slave duties in Surratt's court, full of gaudily dressed Seanchan lounging around and being generally obnoxious. Surath orders Loyal to sing, and he does. A low rumbling that makes a plant on the table begin to grow. Seanchan laugh and clap at Surath's little plaything, and I want to punch all of their faces. In the hallway, fellow slave Ingtar tells Loyal that the horn is in Turok's Room of Curiosities and is barely guarded. Egwene is another story. She's being kept in the kennels with other Demane, and the horn is more important anyway. Loyal insists they will find a way to rescue her, and knows how strong she is, despite only knowing her for a day and a half. Egwene is in her cell, having picture dreams about cracking Rena over the head and beating the hell out of her. But you're not listening, Egwene. You can't even pick up anything you might think of as a weapon. Rena says they'll do no more training until Egwene can pick up the pitcher only to pour water. She tells Egwene that she can feel how powerful she is, and that strong Demane are the hardest to break. But it doesn't look like she's worried it won't happen. When Rena leaves, Egwene longingly stares out her cell window at a beautiful tree that will surely stand forever. Ishamael visits Min in her dreams. Their deal was he would take away her curse when she brought Matt to Kyrian. But he is altering the deal. Pray he does not alter it any further. Now, she has to get Matt to leave here with Rand. Lan, Alana, and her warders stop for the night at an outdoor temple to the Forsaken. Lan says he will need Swan's permission in order to return to the tower. And Alana tells him Swan's not there, she's returning from a trip to Camelin, which was just the information Lan needed to try and sneak off to find her. Unfortunately, the others were waiting for this, since they now think Lan is a Lanfear stan. Lan doesn't want to be murdered, so he spills the beans that he and Moraine found the dragon reborn. Rand is having another I killed all my friends dream. As he sobs, Ishamael shows up to taunt him. Lanfear appears, calls him Ishi, and sends him away. See, Rand, she's nice. She tells him a little more about the dream world, including that you can visit and talk to anyone you want. Rand says Egwene, so he's not good at making Lanfear think he loves her. But she does take him to Egwene's cell, and they talk for just a moment before Lanfear ends it. Rand demands to know where she is and says he'll do anything. Egwene awakens from her dream and calls for Rand, but then just assumes she's losing it. Rand's dead, remember? She hears a voice from the cell next door, but the other woman isn't very conversational. She's just repeating the lessons that her Soldam taught her. Rima Sadai went out of her way to secure passage on a ship for Nynaeve and Elaine, so they can get back to the tower and rat out Liandrin. But they are not leaving here without Egwene. Rima pulls out an item and tells the girls to rescue her. They will have to figure out how to open it. Moraine is sitting at her desk trying to pen a letter to Swan about how she's been stilled. Barthanas enters with some little sandwiches Moraine used to like, but per usual, Moraine is rude as hell, so he leaves. In the hall, Anver sees how upset he is and busts in to chew Moraine out for being such a bitch and for not coming home when their father was on his deathbed. But Moraine can't tell her that she was busy looking for the dragon reborn. No one should ever tell anyone about that. Anver tries to throw her out, but Moraine pulls the older sister card, and my husband continues to hate her. Swan is traveling in her carriage, which is suddenly stopped by an approaching horse. Swan has some halo knife weaves ready to attack, but the door flies open and it's just Lan, and he is ready to spill all the tea. Rand interrupts Loghain playing stones and demands Loghain show him battle weaves. He says teaching him is the only way for Loghain's life to matter. Loghain tells him not to surrender to the power, but to take it. Rand overdoes it immediately and almost burns himself out. Puke count, 2. Loghain tells him he can fight anyone with that much power, so I guess that was enough lessons? Rand overhears his gambling friend Matt as he walks through the foregate. They have an emotional reunion, and Matt asks Rand where everyone else is, so they grab a drink to catch up. Rima and the girls are working on how to open the Eidem, which they figure out is a Tirangrial. Rima tells them the story of how she ended up here, traveling with a group of Aes Sedai to investigate the Shanshan threat. A gray and green Aes Sedai and their warders were killed, and a blue sitter was captured. Rima shows them their rings and says they died to get her that Eidem. Rena tells Egwene that an Aes Sedai is the one who created the Eidem. With the Shanshan, Egwene will reach her true power. Together, they look at the tree outside, and Rena guides Egwene into channeling to feel its roots, its sap, and then setting the entire tree ablaze. Rena is so happy about what they've done together, but Egwene still cannot pour that damn water, and Rena snaps, literally kicking her while she's down. Nynaeve tries to convince Elaine that she should go on the ship back to the White Tower, but Elaine has no intention of leaving her only friend. Over drinks, Rand tells Matt that everyone else thinks he's dead. But now Ishamael has Egwene in Falm. Matt insists he will accompany Rand to save her. He just has to let Min know he's going. Min is getting drunk in her room alone. Matt tells her he ran into Rand and he's going with him, but Min tries to stop him by telling him she saw him kill Rand in Falm with the dagger. But how does she know Rand? Matt figures out that Min has been setting him up from the beginning, but she still pleads with him not to go. Moraine has her letter sent to Anaya Sedai. Book shout out. Moraine must have heard my last paragraph about her because she apologizes to Barthanas about how terrible she's been to him. Anvir enters and says, Swan is in Kyrian with 14 Aes Sedai, and she wants to see Moraine. Stop that letter! Swan emerges from her carriage in a courtyard, surrounded by other Aes Sedai warders, including Liandrin, Varen and Tomas, and Yasika. No one's commenting about Liandrin's new cloak color choice. Rand is waiting for Matt, but of course, Matt has decided not to go, and he feels like shit for it. Rand tries to leave the city, but he is stopped by Lan, Alana, Maxim, and Yvonne, and the gang is almost literally all here. Egwene is a bloody mess, working on her pitcher issues. The girls and Rima are channeling into the Eidem. Rima gives Nynaeve some good advice about channeling, but she channels a large burst, which draws the attention of patrolling Demane. Nynaeve says the Eidem cannot be broken, as a knock on the door alerts them that they have been discovered. Rima tells the girls to stay hidden, and asks Nynaeve to return her ring to the flame, so she's got no intention of coming back. Rena enters the cell again, and asks Egwene to pour herself some water, but she still cannot do it. The Demane, Sildam, and Tolgers approach Rima's house, and the streets clear out fast. Rima, my new favorite character, gets started fucking shit up as Basan dives in with his sword. The fight is interspersed with Egwene being asked again to pour the water. When she can't, Rena hangs her from a hook by her collar, and she struggles to breathe. Rima begs Basan to kill her, as they are overrun, but he hesitates and is killed. Egwene is almost dead. Rima knows it's over, but before it is, she breaks every bone in the Soldam's body. Rena saves Egwene at the last second. Elaine and Nynaeve watch from a window, holding hands, as Rima is collared, wailing. Egwene finally pours a cup of water, which Rena dumps onto the floor. She calls her a good girl and leaves, and Egwene chugs the rest of the water from the pitcher. She screams and cries, and we see her neighbor, saying Egwene lasted longer than she did. It's Maegan, the Blue Aja Sitter.